Hey y'all, welcome back to Hopped Up Beer Review. It is another Macro Monday, and we have a special treat. Today, we are drinking Keystone Light from Coors Brewing Company out of Golden, Colorado. Thanks for joining us.
Hey, everybody, welcome to Hopped Up Beer Review, the show where we give you our unprofessional and somewhat biased opinion about the beer we are drinking and reviewing. And sometimes we wear stupid stuff like today. We've got a very.
This is functional. Well,
some of us do.
It is Macro Monday.
It is Macro Monday. We're here to celebrate another Macro Monday and have a treat, as I think Andy alluded to on the special intro. Special treat, yes. I've got one-eyed Andy in the attic. I've got Jay. I'm Militia Ben. What are we drinking today, gentlemen?
Keystone Light. In that real tree camo can. I mean, check that bad boy out. It's good looking, right? Real tree.
Is that why you're wearing that, Ben?
This is why I'm wearing camo. Yes.
Had to do your National Guard duty. You just got back from doing your weekend National Guard duty.
No, I will say cheers to all of our military. Thank you for all that you do. Yes. I have not been in the military and never will be probably. But definitely thank you. Thank you for everything you guys do. Special cheers to you guys. But no, I'm wearing this because of the camo, and it's the only camo I have. And I stole it. Stole it from somebody that we know.
I almost missed the glass pouring this. My depth perception is completely.
And so, Keystone with the Realtree camo. You know, Realtree, one of the big sponsors of Ole Miss.
Yeah.
So
if you have not gotten yourself some Realtree camo, and you find yourself in need of camo, that's the only camo you should get.
Definitely.
And we are not paid by Realtree.
We are not. We'd like to be.
We're just not paid.
Wow, look at that light beer, Ben. Yes.
It's not the lightest we've done, but
no, it's close. I felt it needed a mug, though, today, you know.
Cheers, mates.
Cheers, mates.
Cheers, mates.
Don't miss your mouth, Andy.
Reading is going to be interesting. I've got to. Fortunately, there's not a lot.
Ooh. Well, and this is a Coors product, is it not?
Yes. So Coors, we did Coors Banquet as a Macro Monday last year. So Ben might put a link to Coors for that information. So this is an American light lager. And what does that mean? Technically, it's going to be low carbs, low calories, low alcohol content, high in cereal adjuncts like cereal, like rice and corn.
Rice Krispies and Frosted Flakes.
Corn. Yeah, Frosted Flakes, yeah. Okay. Technically, it's a Frosted Flakes kind of taste to it, you know?
Maybe.
They're great. So, this is 4.1%. 6.8 IBUs. I can't read with one eye. 4.7 carbs. You know, we don't usually do the carbs, but I'm going to get to that later because we have covered carbs with other Coors products. 4.7 carbs, 101 calories. This was first introduced in Chico, California in September 1989. So Keystone Light. And again, as we said, it was part of the Coors Brewing Company out of Golden, Colorado. It is now Miller Coors, the parent company. First started by Adolph Coors, and I'm going from the old Coors. I still can't read. And that started in 1873. He came over in 1868. And so started getting brewing like that. Oh, but fun stuff about Keystone Light. One of the things people remember about Keystone, okay, it's a cheap beer. It's a good, it's technically called like a high school beer or college beer because young, it's very inexpensive and it's low alcohol, low taste, and it's easily crushed. Do y'all remember some of the advertising slogans? I was looking up at some of their marketing. So I'm going to read this. So 2007, it was always smooth, even when you're not Keystone Light. And they had those series of commercials where the guys were just acting like total idiots. And then it, what used to be all stones must be thrown, and it was marketed as bottled beer taste in a can, because Coors had the specially lined cans. So we're going a little bit down memory lane. So the Never Bitter Beer, and you recall the Bitter Beer Face commercials, and they had that guy who could make that really scrunched up face kind of roll his bottom lip over the top. And I was thinking, I was like, what's bitter beer? Because what were they saying was bitter beer back in the day, back in those 90s?
That's a good point, yeah.
And are they talking about craft beer, like actual flavorful beer that you can taste hops and IBUs? Is that what they were talking about? Or are they saying some of the other beer goes skunky, you know, some of the other competing macros? So I don't know. Back in the 90s, my palate wasn't refined enough to know a quality beer when I tasted it. So then another marketing, it says, wouldn't it be great if, and it followed by the drinker's fantasies. I don't remember that one as so much, but I do remember the Keith Stone and the Keystone commercials. So this fictitious character is kind of a smooth guy and dialing phone with beef jerky kind of thing. So that's about it. I was kind of reading of those, I was like, oh my gosh, I completely forgot about all the marketing. And yeah, so the Keystone Light is much more popular than Keystone Premium. It's hard to find Keystone Premium. It's only sold in select markets, really.
Are they buying bulk?
I think Canada was one of the markets.
And I think
it's a Boston Coors product.
And I was gonna say based on our ability or lack thereof to actually find a Keystone Light here, I mean, it sounded like we all had to drive to multiple places, where I would have thought this would have been like in every gas station or store that you would visit.
It used to be like a 30 pack for $10, $10 or $11 some years ago.
And now I got a 15 for $9.
So yeah, I did too.
Yes, I have 14 more.
Inflation.
Yes.
15 for $9, and I think the 30 was 17,
18. How did you not grab that deal?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, I wanted to try the beer beforehand. It's not going to be my go-to filler beer.
So I mentioned the old carbs and all, because when we discussed some of the Colorado Natives that we did here, which is also another Coors Brewing Company out of Golden, Colorado. Colorado Native, we did some of their lower calorie, low ABV beers. We did High Country, which was 3.7 IBUs. That was one of the lowest IBUs we've ever done at 3.7% alcohol at 24 IBUs. And their local was 4.1% alcohol at 20 IBUs, comparing to this, which is 4.1% and 6.8 IBUs. Now, calorie wise, this is pretty low. It's 101 calories. It comes in at 1 calorie less than Coors Light. Coors Light had, it's 0.1%. It's 4.2% versus the 4.1 of Keystone. One calorie heavier at Coors Light than the Keystone Light. Carbs, Keystone Light is lighter at 4.7, where Coors Light was 5. So this is, of the light beers, this is even lighter going Keystone.
And we're seeing a pattern where Coors makes a lot of light beers, mm-hmm. like a lot. So even with their craft brand.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. All right. Has anybody not had this one?
I have, but I can't remember the last time I had it. And
college.
Yeah. I've had it since college because this was also seen in hashes. And I remember running some hashes and Keystone was on them.
Well, then you and I might have had one there.
Yeah. So I got to look to see. But I had never logged it in Untappd.
I did.
Jay, I'm thinking back to that, you know, summer session we had in summer school at Ole Miss where, you know, we were playing some beer pong just about every night and buying really cheap beer.
This was probably included in that. Yeah.
Yeah. So
would have been around 23 years ago.
Yeah, long time. All right.
Course, I mean, the beer's been around since he said 89. So yeah. 34 years this month. Yeah.
All right. Well, Jay, what you think? You got 14 more of these bad boys.
Yeah.
Where do you go with this one?
This is a typical macro, the way I look at it. I mean, it's like we said, you joked about that when we spent those times. I mean, we would just go find whatever the cheapest case of beer was that we could afford and drink it that way. This falls into that category. There's nothing special. It's bland. It's a light lager that has little to no flavor. I mean, it's not as bad as, to me, like a Mick Ultra. This is a pure water, but it's not going to be my filler beer. You know, we've been surprised by a couple of them, but this one was no surprise to me. So, maybe a 5 for me. I mean,
all right, I'll jump in there and go. I think, you know, outside of a beer pong or something like that, there's no real reason to buy this, I guess, unless you just can't afford anything else. It for me is, I mean, it's just above water in the flavor profile, you know. And Jay, you said it, I think it probably is above a Mick Ultra, and we'll have to do one of those at some point. There's little to no flavor here, and it's really interesting when you try to think back to, you know, drinking this in more quantity back in the, you know, 23 years ago or whatever it was. I think back to some of these beers that we had, and I'm like, man, you know, you're choking them down, and now it's like they don't even have any flavor at all. It's just interesting how, you know, the palate changes as you get into different and better beer. So I think this is a steer clear. If you hadn't had it in a long time, let us review it for you and, you know that you don't need it.
Like the beer stuntman.
Yeah, exactly. If somebody hands it to me, I'm going to drink it, but that's about it. I don't need to buy it again. I definitely don't need the 14 that I have in my fridge now.
Just pass them out to kids on the street.
You know? Halloween's coming up soon.
It's like Halloween, yeah. So, yeah.
The can is camouflage, so it does have a costume on already. So it might actually work. I'm going to give it a 4.
It's not the worst macro. It's not the best macro. It's got that just sweet, you know, like we said, cereally taste, corn. Can't tell if that's corn or rice, that sweet beer macro taste. It does have a little more flavor than some of the others. And if, you know, it's free and someone gives it to me, I'm going to drink it. But now that I think of it, you know, like you said, a step above water, this made a good hash beer. And when people are like, what's a hash? The international organization, the Hash House area, is where you run and drink beer. You hit beer stops along the way. You're following a trail. And this was a good one to do, especially when it's hot outside and you're tired and you slow alcohol, got a little flavor. And then you drink enough of them by the end, you're at least feeling better than when you started. But that said, like I said, I'll drink it if somebody hands it to me. It's free and there's no other options. And Ben, I'm going with the same thing as you. It's a 4.0 for me. It's just, yeah.
All right. It is the first Monday of the month, so Macro Monday. That is going to give us a 4.3 for the Keystone Light, and definitely one that if you hadn't had in a while, I think you can definitely skip it. Like we said, we're doing the research for you guys, so you girl, whoever our fan is. But yeah, it's one that, you know, if you need one, hey, I got 14 more. Just tell me where to send it. So with that, be sure to like, subscribe, and cheers to that notification bell, because you're going to want to see all of our Macro Mondays that come up each month. And we'd love for you to check back in on those. You can also check out some of our other videos that we post throughout the week. Also, check us out on all the social medias down below in the description, and come say hey in our Discord server. Let us know if you've ever played beer pong with Keystone Light, like Jay and I have. And we'd love to hear about that. So check us out there. Lastly, if you are interested in any Hopped Up Beer Review merch, like the glass there or shirts or anything of that nature, you can check out our link below as well for some of that if you are so inclined. With that, for Andy, One-Eyed, Eye Patch in the Attic, and Jay, Hottie Toddy, I'm Ben.
Gorillas. Cheers, mates.